us all to take a deep, full breath in through the nose, really filling up the lungs. Open up the mouth and sigh it completely out. We do this two more times, inhaling fully through the nose. Opening up the mouth and releasing. Last time, your deepest, fullest, most expansive breath in. We open up the mouth and let it go. Closing the mouth now. Relax the jaw, the lips, the mouth. Place the tongue to the roof of the mouth, and if you practice Ujjayi breath, start to engage it. Otherwise, maybe challenging yourself to breathe exclusively through the nose for the remainder of our practice. On your next breath in, draw the knees in towards one another. Hug those knees in towards your chest. Give yourself a little squeeze. Gentle rocks from side to side. Then sliding your hands underneath your knees, we begin to rock and roll forwards and backwards, massaging the spine, gaining momentum. And on your next roll forward, cross at the ankles, plant the hands, step back, downward facing dog. Take a moment in your downward facing dog to get comfortable. Feel free to pedal out the feet, bending one knee, bending the other, swaying the hips, shaking out the head. Any movement that feels good to you right now, remembering that this is your practice, your body. So listen to it, work with it. I'm here to guide you, but I want this to feel good for you. Today's practice is a dynamic practice. It is open level, so it is there for all of you, but please only go as far as feels right. Now on your next inhale, come high up onto the balls of the feet, bend the knees, but keep lifting the hips towards the sky, melting your chest towards your thighs, opening through the shoulders. Start to straighten out the legs. Inhale, right leg floats high to the sky. Come onto the left fingertips. Now option to stay here, option to start walking that left hand back, playing with your balance, pressing into that right hand, left foot. Maybe the left arm floats up towards the sky. We take a breath here. Release the left hand, release the right foot. Come high up onto the balls of the feet. Once again, we bend the knees, lift the hips, melt the chest towards your thighs. As you straighten out through the legs, start to bring your heels towards the left, your toes to the right, coming forward into a plank position. Strengthen that left hand as the right arm floats up and then towards the front. Lifting the hips nice and high, getting a stretch through the right side of your body. Take an inhale here. As you exhale, release the right hand down. Come back onto the balls of the feet in your plank position. Lower the knees, the chest, the forehead to the ground. Tucking the pelvis, rounding out through the back, we ripple forward into a cobra or an upward facing dog. Exhale, press the hips towards the heels, tuck the toes, downward facing. Inhale, left leg floats high to the sky. Come onto the fingertips of the right hand. Option to stay here, maybe you start to walk that right hand back. Option to float the right arm up to the sky. Shifting the weight into that left hand, right foot. If you fall, don't worry, just come right back. We release the right hand, lower the left foot down. Last time, come high up onto the balls of the feet. Bend the knees, melt the chest, take your gaze between your hands. Straighten out the legs and tiptoe your feet all the way forward. Find a nice rag doll at the top of the mat. Head and neck relax, feet are hip distance apart. Option to grab onto opposite elbows. If you're grabbing onto opposite elbows, reach those elbows towards the front as you relax the head and the neck. Option to bring your hands behind your head, drawing your chin to your chest. Option to take the hands behind your back and release the fingers. Remember that this is your practice. Find a stretch that feels good and then move in a way that feels good. Maybe you sway, maybe you bend one knee, bend the other. Taking one more breath in your forward fold. With your next exhalation, release the hands down to the ground. Gentle bend of both knees, we draw our chin to the chest and start to roll ourselves up. Vertebra by slow vertebra. Head and neck are the last things that come up. Now as they do, take the shoulders up, back, and down. Reach the right arm behind you, grabbing onto your left elbow. Draw your right ear towards your right shoulder and stretch out the left side of your neck. Keep pulling that left arm down as you lengthen through the left side of your neck. Take an inhale here as you exhale. Draw your chin towards your right collarbone, gazing down to the right side of your mat. can either keep your feet hip distance apart or you can heel toe your toes to touch. Come back to the breath, come back to the body. Take a moment to remind yourself of your intention for today's practice. Wherever you are in the world, I'm so grateful that you are here. I hope you have a fabulous practice. All right, yogis, as we inhale, sweep the arms, high to the sky. Exhale, dive down to the ground, forward fold, head and neck relax. Inhale as you lift and lengthen. Exhale, plant the hands, step or jump, your vinyasa, knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhaling through cobra or upward facing dog, we exhale, press back, downward facing dog. Find your breath in downward facing dog, taking a moment for alignment, making sure the feet are hip distance apart, the hands at least shoulder distance. Index or middle finger points forward as we spread those fingers nice and wide, pressing into the ground, finding lift through the hips, and then lowering through the heels. Take an inhale in your downward facing dog. As you exhale, bend the knees, look forward, step or jump to the top of the mat. Inhale, find length, and exhale, fold back down. We inhale, sweep the arms high to the sky, roots rise. Exhale, dive back down, forward fold. Inhale as you lift and lengthen. Exhale, plant the hands, step or jump, your vinyasa once again, high to low. Inhale, coming forward and up. Exhale, we press back, downward facing dog, and breathe. Now, a lot of times in our yoga practice, it can be quite easy for us to fall into habit, for our mind to wander. Take a moment and see what you can do to challenge yourself to go deeper, to stay focused in the here and the now. Can you squeeze the forearms towards one another? Draw the toes in and the heels out without moving your feet. Squeeze the inner thighs, draw the navel and the ribs in. We take an inhale. As you exhale, bend the knees, look forward, step or jump between your hands. Inhale to find length, and exhale, release. Bend the knees, sink the hips, inhale, Uttanasana, chair pose. Exhale, forward fold, Uttanasana, the head and the neck relax. Inhale to find length, exhale, plant the hands, step or jump, high to low, your vinyasa. Inhale, find length, engage those glutes. Exhale, use the core to lift the hips up and back. Inhale, right leg sweeps high to the sky. Exhale, right foot steps between your hands. Arms float up as we inhale to a high-level lunge. Exhale, open up, warrior two. Front palm flips, inhale, reverse. Keep the bend in that right knee. Exhale, cartwheel the hands down. Silently stepping, right foot back. Shift the weight forward as you bend the elbows. Inhale to lift. Exhale, squeeze hands and feet downward facing. Inhale, left leg sweeps high to the sky. Exhale, left foot steps between your hands. Arms float up to a high level lunge. Inhale. Exhale, warrior two. Back heel drops. Arms open wide. Front palm flips. Inhale to reverse. Exhale, hands cartwheel down. Left foot steps back. Shift the weight forward. Bend the elbows. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, back. Downward facing. And breathe. Working with your breath in downward facing dog. Slowing that breath down, reminding yourself that with your breath comes your energy. We're gonna do one more round of that variation of Surya B. Before we start to move through today's flow, we've only got two rounds of our flow today. I'll explain it the next time we get to downward facing dog. Take a lovely deep inhale here. As you exhale, bend the knees, look forward, step or jump between your hands. Inhale to find length. Bend the knees, sink the hips, inhale, Uttanasana. Exhale, forward fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, flat back, gaze goes up. Exhale, plant the hands, step or jump, high to low. Inhaling, we lift and lengthen. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, right leg sweeps high to the sky. Exhale, right foot steps between your hands. Arms float up as we ground through the feet, inhale. Exhale, back heel drops, arms open wide, warrior two. Front palm flips, reverse as you inhale. Exhale, hands cartwheel down. How silently can you step that right foot back as you shift the weight forward and bend? Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, left leg sweeps high. Exhale, left foot steps between your hands. Arms float up, inhale. Warrior two. Cartwheel down, silently step, left foot back, shift forward as you bend, inhale, Exhale. Downward facing dog. And we breathe. All right, yogis, staying in your downward facing dog. I'll explain today's class a little bit. We're gonna move through two rounds of a flow. Both rounds will be exactly the same. The first round, we're gonna work through a few drills so you get the hang of what we're doing. The second round, you're gonna have the opportunity to move one breath, one movement. I'm already out of breath. So, going only as far as feels right. Some of these drills are a little bit challenging. Hopefully the repetitive nature of the first round will allow you to really enjoy the second round, because we'll be moving kind of like in a moving meditation, as if it were a dance. All right, yogis, taking one more breath where you are. Let's start with our flow. Inhale, right leg sweeps high to the sky. Exhale, right knee to right tricep, squeeze it in. Inhale, float the leg up and back. Exhale, right knee to opposite elbow. Drop your back heel, straighten the right leg. Left arm floats up to the sky. Now there's an option to stay here, or bring your left hand behind your head, float the right foot off the ground. We inhale here, as you exhale, crunch elbow to knee. And inhale, straighten out. Two more times, we crunch. Inhale, straighten. Last time, crunch and straighten. Left arm floats up to the sky. As we exhale, left hand down, right knee to your nose, hold tiger pose. All right, yogis, come onto the outer edge of your left foot. Bring your right foot behind you, right arm floats up to the sky. Wild thing. Now two options for the next move. You can either bring your right hand down and step your right foot forward, or you can keep that right hand lifted. Shift the weight into the left side of the body. Lift the right knee and step it top of the mat. Right hand comes down. Now, this is something I love doing, quite different. Shifting your weight into your hands and that right knee. We're gonna take an inhale. As you exhale, bring your left knee to your left elbow and step it back. Exhale, knee to elbow, step it back. Last time, we crunch, step it back. Lower your left knee to the ground, float the arms up, Anjaneyasana. Now take a moment in Anjaneya. To find that alignment, you want the hips to be shifting forward, but instead of collapsing downwards, keep the lift so you get the nice stretch through that left hip flexor, squeezing the feet towards one another, lengthening through the fingertips. Now tuck your left toes under. We are going to inhale, draw that left heel towards your glute, and then release the left foot, straighten the right leg, and fold. Exhale. Inhale, Anjaneyasana, draw the heel towards your glute. Exhale, release, straighten right leg, and fold. One more time, we inhale, heel to glute. Exhale, fold over that right leg, arms hover back, energetically pull the right heel towards you, open up through the chest. Next breath, we're gonna bend through the right knee, lift the left knee, arms float up, high lunge, hold your high lunge. All right, guys, in your high lunge, square the hips off, pulling the right hip back, left hip forward. Tailbone is pulling you down towards the ground. Back leg is straightening out. Once again, we're pulling. We're getting a nice stretch through that left hip flexor. Right knee over right ankle. Bend into that right knee. Create space in the shoulders. Lengthen through the fingertips. Draw ribs and navel in towards the spine. We take an inhale here as you exhale. Warrior two. Hold your warrior two. I'm still catching my breath. Right heel in line with your back arch. Now the weight of the front foot's in that front heel, weight of the back foot's in the outer edge so you don't collapse into that inner arch. Open up through the hips, feel the expanse. That right knee should be pressing out. You can even angle the right feet, the right toes out a little bit. Can you sit a little lower? Lengthen out through the arms, grow taller through the crown of the head. We flip the front palm, reverse our warrior, keep the bend through the right knee. Exhale, right forearm to thigh. Left arm reaches across. All right, extended side angle. Keep pressing the right knee away, bending into the right knee, lowering the left hip, pressing into the outer edge of that left foot. We're gonna circle our left arm three times. So reach that left arm back, down, round the ground, forward, and up. We exhale, reach the arm back, down, forward, and up. Last time, reach the arm back, down. As it comes forward and up, straighten the right leg, bend the left knee, Skandasana to the back of your mat. Now, Skandasana, surfer's lunge, can be a challenging pose. So if you can't go that far, go as far as your knee allows you. There's an option to bring your hands to the floor, or you can come all the way down with your hands in prayer. Now, there's a nice stretch here. That heel energetically pulls in towards you, toes pointing up towards the sky. We're gonna run through this three times. You can use your hands or not, you can go as far as you would like. Now shifting our weight, we're gonna press into that left foot, lift ourselves up, shift to the top of the mat, right arm floats up to the sky, your feet turn to the right, drop your left hip, drop the right arm. Reversing what we just did, sweep the right arm around, turn your feet to the left, bend left knee, Skandasana. Let's try that again. Lift the weight, shift forward, toes turn to the right, lower the hip, lower the right arm. We reverse what we did, coming all the way around, bending that left knee. All right, yogis, last time, come forward. I have a teacher that calls this lazy lizard, so let's stick with that. Exhale here, inhale, runner's lunge, right hand to the outside of your right foot, step the right foot back, vinyasa. You can always skip vinyasas, coming straight back into downward facing dog. We are going to take 5 breaths here. All right, yogis, before we move on to the left-hand side, you can stay in down dog, you can take child's pose, you can come onto your forearms. Now, because this is an open level class, and it is dynamic, I'm gonna give you guys the option to lower your left forearm but keep your right hand on the ground. Make sure your right hand is in line with your left elbow. Draw the left hand towards the middle of your mat. Float the right leg high to the sky. Now you can shift your weight forward, dropping the crown of the head down, and maybe play with lifting yourself up. Otherwise, stay exactly where you are. Wherever you are is perfect. We have 2 more breaths here. Allow yourself to regroup, to reset. We're gonna do the exact same thing on the left-hand side. Take 1 more breath wherever you are. If you're in child's pose on your forearms or upside down, start to make your way back into downward facing dog. All right, guys, let's do this. Inhale, left leg floats high to the sky. Exhale, left knee to left tricep. Inhale, float the leg up and back. Exhale, we twist, left knee, right elbow, drop the back heel, straighten that left leg, right arm up to the sky. Right hand behind your head, optional. Option to lift that left foot off the ground. We exhale, crunch, right elbow to left knee. Inhale, straighten. Exhale, crunch. Inhale, straighten. Last time, we crunch. Inhale, right arm reaches up to the sky. As we exhale, right hand down, left knee to nose. Come onto the outer edge of your right foot. Left foot behind you, left arm reaches. As we come into Wild Thing, press the hips, engage the glutes, open the heart. Now you have the option to drop left hand down, left foot to the front, or you hover the left foot and step it to the top of the mat. We release the left hand to the ground in a runner's lunge. Shift the weight into your hands and your left foot. Inhale here as you exhale, crunch, knee to elbow. Inhale it back. Crunch, knee to elbow. Inhale it back. Last time we crunch. Inhale it back, release the right knee to the floor. Sweep your arms up. Anjanasana. Take a moment to find that alignment. So once again, shifting the hips forward, but instead of collapsing into the pose, which a lot of us hypermobile yogis do, I want you to squeeze the feet so you get that lift coming up, that length through the right hip flexor. Arms float high to the sky. Open the shoulders, open the heart. Now tuck your back toes under. We're gonna draw that right heel towards our right glute. Release the toes, straighten the left leg. Left toes point up as we hover our chest down. Inhale, Anjanasana with that right heel to glute. And then exhale, straighten it up. One last time. We inhale, squeeze that heel in. Exhale, straighten that left leg. Hover here. Energetically, pull the left heel towards you. Navel drawing down, but chest is opening up. Now with our next breath, bend into the left knee. Lift the right knee. Arms come up. High level lunge. All right, guys. Taking a moment in high lunge to find that alignment. We square the hips off. Left hip draws back, right hip forward. Front knee bends to a 90 degree bend. Remember, if you're wobbling in this pose, feet should be hip distance apart so that you can square the hips off, so that you have that stability as you ground down and then lift up. Belly and ribs draw in. Fingers reach high. We inhale. Exhale, open up, warrior two. Front heel in line with back arch. We angle our foot. Back foot should be angling more forward than back. Press into the outer edge. Sink into the hips. Open the thighs. Left knee draws up. Flip the front palm. Inhale, reverse your warrior two. Bend through that left knee. Exhale, extended side angle. Or thigh. Right arm reaches up and across. Our aim here is to try to get a nice straight line from our right fingertips to the edge of our right foot. So see if you can lower the hips a little further. Opening up that right shoulder as your gaze goes up. We circle the arms, the right arm, reaching that right arm back, down, forward and around. Two more times, we circle back, down, forward and around. Last time, circle it back, down. As we come forward, straighten the left leg, bend the right knee. Surfer's lunge on the right side. Now remember, hands can be on the floor. If you can't go all the way down, stay in a half squat, but feel the stretch as you lift those left toes up towards the sky. We're gonna move through this three times once again. So we inhale here, exhale to the top of your mat, turn your toes to the left, left arm reaches up and down as the right hip lowers. Reverse what you did, take your toes to the right, bend your right knee. We'll do that again, shift the weight forward. Toes to the left, drop the right hip, drop the left arm. Inhale, come around, surfer's lunge to the right. Last time, guys, shift it forward. Lazy lizard, left arm reaches. Sweep back to a runner's lunge, plant the left hand, left foot steps back. Your vinyasa, always optional, or join us in downward facing dog. All right, guys, that was our flow. Remember, if you did the tripod variation on the other side, this time lowering your right forearm to the ground, left hand in line with that right elbow, bring that right hand to the center of your mat, crown of the head is towards that right hand so that you're creating that triangle for your tripod, lifting the left leg to the sky, and then option to go upside down. Otherwise, you can come onto your forearms for dolphin. Dolphin is one of the best shoulder openers, shoulder strengtheners. Otherwise, child's pose. I'm completely out of breath, so child's pose would be my choice right now. We're gonna take two more breaths wherever we are. You guys are doing fantastic. Now, the great thing about the next round is that we'll be moving faster. No drills, one breath, one movement, but I am gonna break the two rounds up, so we're gonna come back to the top of the mat. If you're not already in a downward facing dog, make your way back. Take a lovely deep inhale here. As you exhale, bend the knees, look forward, step or jump to the top of the mat. Inhale, find length. Exhale, release the head and the neck. Now separate your feet, hip distance apart. Grab onto your big toes with your two-piece fingers. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, release the head and the neck. Bend the elbows, melt the chest towards your thighs. Now, anytime that we're in a forward fold, we have a tendency to push the hips back. So shift the weight into the balls of the feet. Try to get those hips to stack over the ankles as you stretch out through the hamstrings. Head and neck are completely relaxed, creating space in the shoulders. Pulling on those toes, we don't have a lot of pulling in yoga. So take advantage, engage those bicep muscles. Take one more breath here. Slowly release that toe grip. Separate the feet a little bit wider. And find your malasana squat, your yogic squat. All right, I love functional mobility. I learned this at a festival I was at a few weeks ago. So you have the option to hold your malasana squat, elbows in the knees, pressing the knees out, hands in prayer at heart center. Those of you that want to play a little bit, I want you to lower your hips to the ground, come to seated. Take your knees, point them to the left-hand side, lift the hips up, press the hips forward, get a nice little stretch here. Lower yourself back down, bring the knees back up. This is the tough part. Can you come up into that yogic squat again? And then lower yourself back down. take your knees to the right, lift the hips, press the hips forward, lower the hips back down, come back to center, lift yourself back up. All right, guys, well done. Wherever you are, hopefully we're back in a malasana squat. We're gonna move through a vinyasa. Feel free to go there now. Otherwise, if you'd like to take a quick crow pose, bringing the hands down to the ground, knees as high up towards the armpits as they go. Shift the weight forward as you come onto the tips of your toes, gaze to the top of the mat. Maybe one foot hovers, maybe both. If you can, lift the heels a little higher, draw the navel in, push the ground away. Move through your vinyasa. We all meet back in a downward facing dog. All right, guys, giving you a moment to all reach downward facing dog. Good news is, last round of our power flow. Let's get started. Inhale, right leg floats high to the sky. Exhale, right knee to right tricep. Inhale, float the leg up and back. Exhale, right knee to left elbow, fall in triangle as the left arm floats up. We inhale, exhale, lower the left hand, right knee to nose, tiger pose. Come onto the outer edge of your left foot, right foot behind you, lift the hips, open the heart. Start to lift the right foot. Maybe you lower the right hand, maybe not. Step the foot to the top of the mat. Lower your left knee, we inhale, Anjanasana. We exhale, straighten out, Ardha Hanuman, half splits. Inhale, crescent lunge, right knee bends, left knee lifts up. Exhale, warrior two. Front palm flips, inhale, reverse. Exhale, extended side angle, forearm to thigh, left arm reaches. Inhale, left arm reaches back, right leg straightens, Skandasana, left side. Exhale, top of the mat, lazy lizard, left hip lowers, so does the right arm. And then come back to the runner's lunge, inhale, exhale, vinyasa, high to low. Inhale, find length, exhale, down dog, left side, inhale, left leg floats high to the sky. Exhale, left knee to left tricep, inhale, we lift. Exhale, left knee to right elbow, fall in triangle, straighten that left leg, right arm reaches. Exhale, right hand down, left knee to nose. Come onto the outer edge of your right foot, left foot behind you. Lift the hips, open the heart, we inhale. Exhale, left foot to the top of the mat. Lower left hand, lower right knee. We inhale, Anjane. Exhale, Ardha Hanuman, straighten the left leg. Hover the body forward. High lunge, bend that left knee, tuck the back toes. Right knee lifts. Warrior two as you exhale. Front palm flips, inhale to reverse. Exhale, extended side angle. Inhale, surfer's lunge. We sweep the right arm back, straighten the left leg, bend the right knee. Exhale, lazy lizard. Turn the feet to the left, lower the hip, lower the left arm. Inhale to a runner's lunge. Exhale, vinyasa, high to low. Inhale, we find length. Exhale, release. Hold downward facing dog for 5 breaths. Option to stay here. Option to take child's pose. Option to come back onto your forearms. Work with the breath. Slow that breath down. All right, guys. That actually moved a little bit faster than I expected. We've got a good 5 minutes or more on our side. So I'm gonna challenge you to do that one more time. I think the more we repeat it, the more fun it becomes. And I really think you guys have got this. So let's do it. If you're not already in a downward facing dog, come back to join me. I promise you, this will be the last round. We inhale, float the right leg high to the sky. Exhale, right knee to right tricep. Inhale, reach it up and back. Exhale, we twist to fall in triangle. Right leg straightens, left arm reaches as you inhale. Exhale, left hand down, right knee to nose. Come onto the outer edge of your left foot. Right foot touches, we inhale to lift the hips and open the heart. Exhale, right foot to the top of the mat. Lower your right hand, left knee. Inhale to Anjanasana. Exhale, Ardha Hanuman, half splits. High lunge is our next pose. We bend the right knee, lift the left knee. Exhale, warrior two. Front palm flips, we inhale to reverse. Exhale, extended side angle, left arm reaches. Now take that left arm back as you straighten the right leg, bend the left knee, Skandasana. Exhale, lazy lizard, we come to the top of the mat. Feet turn to the right, drop the hip, drop the arm. Inhale to a runner's lunge. Exhale, Vinyasa, or straight back into down dog. Moving straight onto that left-hand side. Left leg floats high as we inhale. Exhale, left knee to left tricep. Inhale it up and back. Exhale, we twist, fall in triangle. Right arm reaches as we inhale. Exhale, right hand down, left knee to nose. Outer edge of your right foot, left foot touches, lift the hips, open the heart. Exhale, left foot to the top of the mat. Drop the left hand, drop the right knee. Arms float up, we inhale. Exhale to straighten. Cover the chest, cover the arms. High lunge, bend the front knee, lift the back knee, we inhale. Warrior two, exhale. Front palm flips, inhale, reverse. Extended side angle. Forearm to thigh, right arm up and over. Reach that right arm back as you straighten left leg, bend right knee. Shift the weight forward, lazy lizard, feet to the left. Lower the hip, lower the arm. Inhale to that runner's lunge. Step the left foot back, high to low. Down dog. Well done, guys. That was tough, but it felt great. I hope you feel great. Wherever you are, let's slow it down. So either staying in down dog, taking a child's pose, coming back onto those forearms. You are gonna have 5 breaths here. Please do whatever feels good to you before we move on to the slower part of our practice as we start to bring things down a notch. Coming back to the breath, coming back to the body, reminding yourself of your intention. The music's changed, so it means we're slowing down. When you finish your 5 breaths, I'd like you all to take a child's pose. So lowering the knees to the floor, bringing your hips to the heels. Several options for child's pose, maybe knees apart. Hips to heels, arms reaching forward. Maybe knees together, arms reaching back so you open up through the shoulder blades. Wherever you are, let's slow it down. I have a wonderful teacher who describes the transition from our dynamic practice to the more restorative part of our practice as our ability to stir things up, our ability to move things within the body when we're in the dynamic part, so that when we slow down, we're better equipped to pay attention to what comes up. These are probably the most important parts of our practice. When we practice non-attachment, that's the ego too. So often we come onto our mat wanting to work on ourselves, but a lot of times in group classes, we're watching other people, we're comparing, we're competing. So appreciate for a moment that this is your practice, that you're there on your own if you are there on your own. Remembering that we're never really alone. Come back to that breath, come back to your intention. You are exactly who you are, where you're meant to be. Take a moment to celebrate your body, celebrate your practice, celebrate your ability to take deep breaths, to breathe life into your body. Let's share that beautiful energy around the world, especially towards so many that need help right now. Taking one more moment where you are. And then shifting the weight forward into a tabletop position. Tucking the toes under, we lift the hips up and back. Find downward facing dog. All right, yogi, so we'll continue with something similar to our flow. I want you to reach the right leg high to the sky. As you exhale, bring your right knee to your left elbow. Come back into fallen triangle. Right leg straightens, back heel drops. Left arm floats up to the sky, we lift the hips. As you exhale, lower your hips to the floor. You're in a wide-legged seated posture. Draw the navel in, reach the arms up to the sky. We're gonna tilt the pelvis back, coming into an anterior pelvic tilt, drawing the navel down towards the ground, reaching the arms forward. Now, you can bring your hands down, forearms down, wherever you can reach. If you want to keep this an active stretch, try reaching your arms forward and just holding here. Now, the weight of your upper body is
putting a bit of strain on the back of the legs to open up a little bit. See if you can hold here, using your core to keep you hovering for another three, for two. And then if your hands aren't already on the ground, lowering yourself down wherever you can go. Really aiming on pulling the navel towards the ground. Unless you would like a spinal stretch, you can draw your chin towards your chest and just roll yourself down here. You'll feel it much more in the back, less in the hamstrings. Taking one more breath here. Slowly, we lift ourselves back up. Now this is where it gets a little challenging. Bring your right hand back onto the right corner of your mat. We're gonna lift the hips. You're gonna drop the inside of that left foot. Left arm floats up. Bring that left hand down. Draw your right knee towards your nose. Come onto the outer edge of that left foot. Take your right foot back. Lift the hips in wild thing. Lower the hips down. Bring that right sole of the foot on the inside of your left leg. Now if you're facing the back of your mat and not me, hopefully you're okay. We're in Janu Shirshasana. We're gonna lift the arms high to the sky as we inhale. Exhale, fold over that left leg. Keep drawing the hip back. Keep drawing the belly down towards that left thigh. Taking one more breath here. Slowly, we start to roll ourselves up. Bring that left hand behind you. Draw the right knee in as the right foot plants on the ground. Lift the hips, right arm reaches. Lower your right hand, right shin to the top of the mat. We come into our pigeon press. Open the chest as you inhale. Exhale. Always asking yourself why you're in the posture that you are in. What should you be feeling? Always staying away from anything that feels painful. You want to feel this stretch in your glute and your right IT. Any movements to find the right stretch for you. Once you find it, surrender. Release yourself into the pose. Lovely deep breaths, breathing into any areas of tension or discomfort as you exhale, release, let go, surrender. I mean this emotionally, physically, mentally. And one more breath for you. Leg up into the sky, give it a nice little shake, and then lower it down to the ground. Changing sides, the left leg floats high to the sky. We draw that left knee to our left tricep. Inhale, reach it up, and then twist. Left knee to right elbow, fall in triangle. Lift the hips, lift that right arm, and then release your hips down to the ground. Once again, we inhale, float our arms up. Tilt the pelvis back, draw the belly down, and the fingers reach forward. Staying with me, we cover here for three, for two, and then release yourself down into that wide-legged seated out of the belly towards the ground, trying to maintain the length of the spine. Yeah. See if you can get those toes left. Take one more breath. There we are. Right hand down, left knee to your nose in tiger pose. Come onto the outer edge of your right foot, left foot behind you. Lift the hips, open the heart as you inhale. Exhale, lower the hips to the ground. We're facing the back of our mat. Left sole of the foot on the inside of that right leg. Right toes are flexed, navel draws in. Our arms reach up to the sky as we inhale. Tilt the pelvis back, reach the fingers forward, and release down. That right hip into the hip socket. Take one more breath here. Slowly start to roll your draw that left knee in towards your chest, plant the left foot down, reach the right hand behind you to the right corner of your mat, lift the hips, open the heart. As you exhale, release, left hand down, and then bring your left shin between your hands. That left knee should be pointing out towards the left hand side. Try to release the hips down to the ground. If you need any props, by all means, move over the chest. Inhale, and then exhale, surrender down. Give it a good old shake, and then release that left foot down to the ground. Take an inhale in your downward facing dog. As we exhale, bend the knees, look forward, step or jump through to seated. Come to lie down on your back. All right, I thought this mic might become an issue in my back. All right, we're gonna take a moment for a back bend and then final supine twist. So drawing those heels as close to your bum as they can get, keeping the feet hip distance apart. We want the toes to angle more in than out. You're gonna tuck the pelvis, start to lift the hips up, engaging the glutes. So lifting with the glutes and not your lower back. Keep squeezing the inner thighs in towards one another. Most of us, our toes are gonna wanna point out and our knees are gonna wanna open. So keep squeezing inwards as you lift through the hips. Maybe the arms come behind your back, interlace the fingers as you shimmy from shoulder to shoulder. If anyone would like to go further, hands come either side of the head. As you lift up, maybe you come onto the crown of the head, and with your inhale, find your full wheel variation. Work your breath, keep trying to get those toes in. Inner thighs squeezing in, glutes engaged, always protect the back. Taking one more breath here, drawing your chin to your chest, releasing. If you're in a bridge, arms release and then lower vertebra by slow vertebra. Take your feet mat distance apart. Windshield wipe your knees from side to side. Alright. Keeping those knees bent. I want you to keep the left foot planted on the ground. Bring your right knee in towards your chest. Give yourself a little squeeze. Grab onto the outer edge of your right foot. Take a half happy baby. So that right knee is drawing towards the right armpit. Option to straighten that left leg long on your mat.
Don't go chasing waterfalls. Please stick to the rivers and the lakes that
take one more breath here. Grabbing onto your big toe, your two-piece fingers, we inhale to straighten that right leg up to the sky. If you need to grab onto something, maybe a shirt, if you have a strap. Otherwise, you can take your hands behind your legs. With our next inhale, we lift the head, draw our nose towards our knee, holding here for 3, for 2, for 1. Release as you bend that right knee. Take your hips a little bit over to the right, and then draw that right knee across your body, coming into a supine twist. Try to keep that right shoulder connected to the ground, allowing that twist to deepen naturally. The more that you let go, take one more breath in your twist. Slowly coming back to center. Plant the right foot down on the ground, keeping that right knee bent. Bring your left knee towards your chest. Squeeze it in, grab onto the outside of that left foot. Come into a half happy baby pose. Drawing that left knee in towards your armpit. Maybe you
left arm as you take your gaze to the left hand side. Finding that supine twist on the left. Releasing, letting go. Slowly coming back through center. All right, yogis, I want you to draw both of the knees in towards your chest. I want you to tense every single muscle in your body. Your head lifts up, your nose touches your knees. I want you to take a deep inhale. Hold your breath as you squeeze, 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 tense everything. Open up the mouth and exhale, release down into your final relaxation pose, Shavasana.
Your legs go long, your feet fall out. Arms either side of the body, away from the body, palms facing up. No longer controlling your breath, no longer controlling your body. I'm going to share something with you that I feel is incredibly relevant for what we are experiencing, and it's something that I've read several times now that really makes me feel a lot better. These are meditations from Bill Gates on why he believes Corona or COVID-19 virus is what it's doing to us. He says, "It is reminding us that we are all equal, regardless of our culture, religion, occupation, financial situation, or how famous we are. This disease treats us all equally. Perhaps we should too. If you don't believe me, ask Tom Hanks, or Prince Charles for that matter. It is reminding us that we are all connected, and something that affects one person can have an effect on another. It is reminding us that the false borders that we have put up have little value, as this virus does not need a passport. It is reminding us, by oppressing us for a short time, of those in this world whose whole life has been spent in oppression. It is reminding us of how precious our health is, and how we have moved to neglect it through eating nutrient-poor manufactured food and drinking water that is contaminated with chemicals upon chemicals. We don't look after our health,